money. Remember, it was the infamous scene in Jerry Maguire. Okay, I'm going to ask you, what are your finances looking like inside your childcare business? All right, Ninja, I know finances can totally be super scary, especially when you're trying to juggle all of these balls inside of your childcare business and everything is on you. But it doesn't have to be like that. Let's get our finances set up from the very beginning so that we are not struggling and frustrated. And instead of having a finance horror story, we can have a fabulous Friday finance every week. All right, meet me inside, Ninja. You got this. Hey Ninjas, welcome back. Nikki B here, and I'm the owner and founder of Childcare Ninjas. In 2006, I started my home childcare business with next to nothing, and I have grown it to a multiple six-figure income with multiple facilities, and now it is my mission to help and equip other women to create and scale a childcare business that is simple, fun, and successful. Every Monday, I'm in here with a new strategy or tip to help you do exactly that inside your childcare business. So if this is your first time here, please click on the subscribe button below, click on that bell, and make sure that you don't miss another episode of Monday Moves. Okay, so the past couple of weeks, I have been helping you in creating five steps to help you set up your childcare business in 5 days. We're on step number four, which is all about setting up your finances. Believe it or not, this can be a fun part, okay? I know when we talk finances, it's wonderful to always, you know, think about, you know, what we can do with our finances and growing our finances, and that's the fun part. But there is a part of getting our finances and keeping them in order that is on a very serious level. So I'm going to take this Monday Moves to help you get set up in your finances inside your childcare business in what I would like to call eight simple steps. Now, since there are eight, I am going to be really, really quick in getting some of these steps to you. So you may have to go back and check out the video again, but we definitely want to make sure that you don't miss any of the steps because each one is important. So, okay, step number one is definitely recognizing the level of financial literacy you already have. I know we all know how to add, we all know how to count, we know what kind of numbers we would like to get in our childcare business, but we want to actually recognize where we sit along the finance literacy level of understanding, you know, financial terms that we may need to know. For instance, like our income, our expenses, interest, and things like that. These are things that we don't like to assume that everybody's already familiar with. And a lot of times, getting hung up on the terminology can really cause us to be frustrated with even dealing and looking at our finances. And we don't want to get frustrated because what frustrates you is going to eventually just have you like not being interested at all. And we can't afford to be like that or have that attitude when it comes to our finances. We have to be front and center. Full attention. Okay. So if we are not already somewhat aware of like the terminology that goes along with dealing with the business side of finances, then we can definitely do a little bit of research, at least do like a Google search, and maybe sit down and talk with someone that you may already know about general financial terms and things like that, that you may be getting confused about or that you don't know about. So definitely let's start there. What is our current financial education as far as we know? And number two, let's be honest about it. Step number two, let's be honest about what we know when it comes to our finances. Most of us come in like, okay, I know how to collect my payments and I know how to put them in the bank and I know how to pay my expenses. And that's great. I mean, we all need to know that. That's the basics of handling a checkbook, correct? But it gets a little bit deeper whenever you're talking business. Let's go to, and I'm going to skip around a little bit on these steps, but just making sure that you have all the steps is the most important part. So with step number three, I'm actually going to give you is, separating your money. Make sure that you have your money separated. Make sure that you are not allowing your business finances and your personal finances to intermingle. This is very, very important, especially if you have decided to make your childcare business an LLC. So when you start to mix your money up, it kind of takes away that protection, and that's a whole nother topic that I know I don't have time for tonight. But I definitely wanted to just mention that. So it is very, very important that you make sure that you keep your finances separate. So you want to get an EIN number, which is kind of like a social security number for your business, when you're getting all set up and everything. And then once you have that, you can go to your bank and open a separate business account for your childcare business. And I don't care if you decide to use your name for your childcare business, or if you really, you know, decide to go full blown into creating a name and getting a doing business name, fictitious name, things like that. If you do that, that's fine, but you just definitely, either way, want to make sure that you have your business monies and accounts separated from your personal accounts. And so do the extra, you know, the extra work to do this, and it will really help you stay on track. It'll help you keep things separate, and that way you can focus on what is business and what is personal. Very, very important. Okay, so step number four, I want to just encourage you to really create some financial goals. Okay. A lot of times we think about goals in every other area, and we think about, you know, things that we want to do and the goals that we want to have for our business and our personal life and all of that. But we need to attach a number to that. It's important to attach a financial number to where you would like to be in, let's say, your first 5 years of doing your childcare business. What number would you like to be making? Without a destination, right? You're just kind of going anywhere, right? But we don't want to be going anywhere. We want to have a very focused, very strong, a very strong focus on where we would like to be and where we want to go. So it's very important to definitely really plan out some financial goals inside your childcare business. So whether or not you would like to be at, you know, $60,000 a year or $100,000 a year in maybe your first 5 years, just start to really make a plan and start to really set some goals when it comes to your finances. Not just saying that I want to be out of my home in 5 years, but, you know, attach a number to that. Look at the things that it might take for you to actually move your childcare business from your home into maybe a small building. And if that is a goal, that's perfectly fine. But attach a number to it so that at least you know where you're focused and where you're headed. You do not want to travel without a destination. So don't open your childcare business and start this journey without a destination. Have a destination, okay? Even financially. I think we're on five, actually. So definitely also make sure that you break down your task into your financial task. I have what is called a financial task list, and I look at that periodically throughout the week, throughout the day, even sometimes, like, did I forget something? But you basically break it down into four areas, which are financial tasks that you need to do daily, weekly, monthly, and quarterly. And there are different things that you definitely need to do on a daily basis. One is just simply keeping track of your receipts. If you're making purchases and things like that, you want to keep track of that You also want to keep track of all of the things that you are doing as far as writing receipts for parents as they're making payments and things like that. So it's very important to keep track of those things on a daily basis. And then maybe at the end of the week, like I said earlier, you know, a fabulous Finance Friday, you actually come and you file all of those things on that particular day. That works for me. It helps me. I don't know. You can try it. But definitely having some tasks that are financial tasks that you know need to be done regularly. And then you can add that into your workflow, which I talked about last week. Okay. And make sure that those things are getting done on a regular so that you don't have a stack of receipts at the end of the year to give to your accountant. Okay. So keep that in mind. Break down these tasks. Think about all of the things you have to do financially and make sure that you break them down into how you need to do them on a daily, weekly, monthly, and quarterly basis. Keep that in mind. It's a big help. Another thing is also Going and talking to your bank person, whether that's like your bank manager or any, whoever you might be close, even maybe a teller at your bank. I think to build a relationship at your bank where you bank is a wonderful, wonderful thing. You never know when it might come in handy. In the very beginning, I was just kind of like, I don't know if I need to really talk to my teller all like that, or the bank person at my bank all like that. I kind of felt silly because I was just starting out in my childcare business, but I kid you not, they can be a wealth of information and a wealth of knowledge. So do not feel like you are too small to start talking to the people that you bank with. I have a wonderful relationship with the bank that I bank with now. And it just grew over time, but it's amazing because oftentimes I will ask them questions, about different things. And sometimes I will just get a random call just to check in and see how things are going, how business is going. And I know that's part of their job, right? But it does feel nice. So don't be afraid to actually start that conversation with your bank that you bank with, even early on, and letting them know, hey, I've been banking here personally for, however long, if they don't know you, but here is what I'm about to do. I'm about to start my childcare business, and I just wanted to, introduce that to you, introduce myself to you, and talk to them. And you never know when you might need them. They can be a wealth of information. So don't think it's too early. Don't feel like you're too small. Definitely start that conversation with your banker. I think it's important. And last but not least, I am going to say a bookkeeper and an accountant are two different needs, okay? But you definitely will at some point, even if it's maybe not early on, need an accountant to really sit down and talk with them about the best ways to help you get your finances in order so that you are actually on the road to reaching the goals that you have set. When you set your financial goals, you need to know how to get there. And planning and talking that over with like your accountant and letting them know, like, okay, I need to know this is my goal for the next 2 years, or this is my goal for next year, what I want to do. Let me know what things I might need to change in how I handle my finances, or whatever, what steps I might need to take. Let me know what I might need to do now so that I make sure I'm on track for the goal that I'm trying to reach next year. It's really crazy because you really don't think about it until you are like maybe sitting down at the end of the year and you're doing your taxes with your accountant, and they're like, oh, I'm going to need to talk to you about, XYZ because you're moving to a higher level or a higher tax bracket. Whereas if you maybe had reached out beforehand, you might have been able to, even start working on that and getting that momentum in order. So do not be afraid to talk to your accountant. I know that I, in the very beginning, coming from a personal mindset with the accountant into a business mindset, was a little different because I was just so used to like, okay, taking my information as an employee and taking my information to the accountant and just having them do my taxes and not really, worry, just help me get as much money back as I can for like my refund, not understanding a whole different level, right? But so definitely, be proactive in talking to your accountant. And if you do come across that point where you need to maybe hire, whether it's temporarily or, for the long haul, you need to hire a bookkeeper inside your childcare business. Your bookkeeper, I kind of like look at it, and some people kind of like intermingle the two, but I look at having my bookkeeper as that person that helps me stay on track throughout the year, and my accountant is more that person that helps me actually get the taxes done and the savings from the taxes and things like that. So if you kind of want to like a general idea of the kind of the difference, like that bookkeeper is making sure that every expense is accounted for, and things like that. You didn't miss any expenses, you're getting all those categories in there and things like that. And that I you kind of work with your bookkeeper all year long. They're making sure that all your receipts are in and things like that. And this is for the person who is just like, I don't want to handle any of that. I want this person to come in and just handle all of these receipts and expenses, and I just want to be able to you know, do like know what's going on, but not have to do that day to day of entering all of those receipts into a database, and having the spreadsheets and all of that. So depending on what level you are at and depending on, you know, what you choose, there is no right or wrong to it. It's just what works best for you. So if working with a bookkeeper throughout the year is best for you time-wise, and that's another thing, time management, especially once your business really starts to take off, having a bookkeeper may be a huge help for you. So these are just things that I wanted to definitely just share with you as possibilities, whether it is right now in the beginning of your childcare business, or maybe you're transitioning into a next level of your business. And so these are some ideas that can hopefully help you. But getting your childcare business finances set up is a must. Okay. And even if you've already started and you kind of feel yourself going kind of sideways, it's not too late to take a deep breath and pull it all together and get it in order. You may need some help to do that, but once you do that, and it is well worth it to get the help, just be honest with yourself. If you need the help, get the help, you know? And there was a point where I had to do that, but trust me when I say getting the help now is going to save you time and it's going to save you money in the long run. So do not be afraid to ask questions. Do not be afraid to start making and talking with those accountants, your bankers, bookkeepers, those financial people that can help you really reach your financial goals. It's very, very important. And the earlier you do it, the better off you'll be. So hopefully these tips were helpful to you. I definitely have a freebie. You know, I never come in here without a freebie. So be sure to click in the link down below and get your hands on my free task list. It's a finance task list. It will help you actually like look at all of the things that you need to get done to make sure that your finances stay on track. So have a look at that. Let me know how it helped you. I hope that this video gave you some information that is definitely a help to you in your finances inside your childcare business. Just, I pray that you do not allow them to get out of hand, because once it's out of hand, it'll cost you so much to get everything back in order in both time and money. And you do not want to do that. It is wonderful to be able to just pull down some reports and send them over to your accountant and say, here's my stuff for the taxes. It's a great feeling. It's a wonderful feeling. And we should be able to feel like that all throughout the year. So less stress. This finances can be wonderful, but they can also be the biggest stressor inside your childcare business. And we don't want it to get that way. So let's set it up right from the start. Okay, Ninja, that is it for tonight. And I hope that this was a huge help to you. Remember, you can always reach out to me over at childcareninjas.com, over on the webpage and inside the blog. You can also join me over on IG. Say hi and let me know how things are going. I always want to know how your childcare ownership journey is going. And please, if you have any questions, let me know. Message me. Tell me how things are going and what you need help on, because I'm definitely here to help you. And I want to see you do great. All right, Ninja, have a wonderful, wonderful week and get those finances in order. But guess what? You got this. I'll see you next time. Bye. For you and your childcare ownership journey, keep me posted. Let me know how things are going. And until next week, have a great week. Bye.